how to give an injection of anticoagulation medicine.
This video will teach you how to give an injection of anticoagulation medicine. This medicine is given subcutaneously. This means it is given into the fatty layer of tissue just below the skin. Common places for older children and adults include at least 2 inches to the right or left of the belly button, the back of the upper arms, or the outer or front of thighs. For younger children, most injections will be given in the thighs, as high up by the hip and as low as the knee, as long as a fold of skin can be pinched up. It is very important to rotate injection sites. This means switching from right side and left side. A helpful reminder is to give to the right side at night and the left side in the morning. You also want to choose a place at least 1 inch away from the last injection. Over time, you may notice hard knots under the skin from the injections. This may be from scar tissue building up. By choosing a different place to inject, you can reduce the risk of scar tissue. If there is an area with a hard knot under the skin, avoid that spot to allow the area to rest and heal. Let's get started. Wash hands with soap and warm water for 20 seconds, or use hand sanitizer. Use a clean work area to lay out your supplies, or lay down a clean towel to make a clean area. Before you begin, you will need a Band-Aid, gauze or tissue, alcohol wipes, the vial of medicine with an empty sterile syringe, or a pre-filled syringe of medication. Also have your sharps container and trash container nearby. If you have the type of syringe that comes pre-filled with your medicine, talk to your anticoagulation provider for special instructions on how to use it. Make sure the medicine is clear. When you look at it, it should be free of particles and not discolored. For a new vial of medicine, apply pressure to the side of the lid until it pops off. Always sterilize or clean the top of the vial with alcohol and let it dry. Do this with new vials as well as those that are already opened. Do not wipe or blow to dry after wiping, because this will reintroduce bacteria to the surface. You can use the same alcohol wipe for the medicine vial and the injection site. Unwrap your Band-Aid. Next, unwrap your clean sterile syringe. You can use these only once. Pull air into the syringe by pulling back on the plunger. The amount of air should be a little less than the amount of medicine you will draw out of the vial. Do not draw up more air than the dose, because this may cause medicine to leak from the vial. Our example dose is 0.37 milliliters. Pull back to the 0.35 milliliters. Remove the syringe cap. Make sure there's plenty of space so that the syringe needle does not poke anyone. Use a sweeping motion to remove the cap. Stick the needle straight down into the vial while the vial is sitting on your workspace. Avoid bringing the vial up to the needle. This can increase the risk for needle stick injury. Push the air in the syringe into the vial of medicine, then turn the vial and syringe upside down. Avoid touching the top of the bottle to keep sterile. Pull back the plunger until you get a little bit more medicine than you need in the syringe. As long as the needle of the syringe remains inside the vial, it is okay to adjust the amount of medicine. Our example dose is 0.37 milliliters. Pull back to the 0.4 milliliters. Check for bubbles. Tap the syringe to get the bubbles to the top. With the needle pointing to the ceiling, slowly push the plunger to push the bubbles out and get the correct amount of medicine. Notice the plunger on the syringe for the correct amount of 0.37 milliliters with no air bubbles. Once you have the correct dose, pull the needle out of the vial. Do not let the needle touch anything. It is ready to use. It is a good idea to have a second person double check your dose before giving the injection. Giving the injection. Clean the skin of your selected injection site with an alcohol swab. You can use the same alcohol wipe that was used for cleaning the vial. Do not use a hot or cold compress before you give the injection. This can affect how the body absorbs the medicine. pinch a fold of the cleaned skin after it is dry. Hold the syringe like a pen and stick the needle in at a 45-degree angle. Slowly push the plunger all the way down. Slow injections may reduce pain and bruising. Release the pinch after the medicine is all in. This helps keep the medicine from leaking from the injection site. Slowly pull the needle out. Do not put the plastic cap back on the needle. Put the whole syringe and needle into the sharps container. Put pressure to the injection site with gauze, even if there is no bleeding, and avoid rubbing the skin. This will help reduce bruising. Do not use a hot or cold compress on the site for 24 hours. Changing the temperature will affect how quickly the body absorbs the medicine. Baths and showers are okay as long as the water is not too hot or cold. Throw away any pieces of plastic and trash to prevent choking hazards. Write the date that the vial was first used using a permanent marker. Safely store the medicine vial out of reach of young children. When you are finished, wash your hands.
Let's review. When opening a new vial, the top of the vial does not need to be wiped down with an alcohol swab. This is false. The top of the medicine vial always needs to be wiped with an alcohol swab before use, even if it has just been opened. I should never recap the needle on a syringe. This is true. Never recap a used needle. Put the whole syringe and needle into the sharps container after you give the injection. Sites where I can give a subcutaneous injection include A. buttocks, B. side or back of the thigh into the fat, C. side of the arm into muscle, D. back of arm into fat, E. choices B and D. The correct answer is E, because both B and D are correct. The side and back of the thigh and the back of the arm are both areas where you can give an injection into the fatty layer of skin called a subcutaneous injection.